Welcome student. This video lecturer, I am going to explain you about the automated storage and retrieval system. In short, sometimes it is called as ASR system. So this is the question paper which has appeared in your examination. Most of the time you will get a question on to explain that what do you mean by ASRS system and how it works and what are the identification techniques used to for raw materials and finished goods. In this video, I am going to cover need for the storage system, then components of ASR system, then categories of ASR system. During any manufacturing, you require to store the material. So this is a list which will tell you that commonly which we see it in a manufacturing company. So raw materials are there. You need to stock the raw materials. So you need to store the purchased materials. You need to store what we call it as a work in progress. And there are some finished products are there which are waiting for the dispatch. There will be some rejections or the scraps which are pending for the rework. So there are certain items will be there which are to be reused. So tooling is the one more area where we need to store the things. We have to store the different cutting tools, jigs, fixtures, dies, because we have to retrieve them as and when is required. So when they are not required, they are supposed to be stored. Spare parts, because time to time for the maintenance we need to have a collection of spare parts. So this also we have to maintain it. Some office suppliers, that also we have to maintain it. Okay, plant records, these are all the certain things which we are supposed to store in any manufacturing activity. So material handling cannot be avoided in logistic, but can certainly be reduced to a minimum level. The productivity potential in logistic can be exploited by selecting right type of the handling equipment. So obviously there are manual systems were there earlier, then comes the mechanized system, then semi-automatic and automatic system. Our focus is on the automatic system. Whichever system we talk about it, so basically it depends upon the how much volume you are going to handle it, how much speed is required by you for the retrieval and the storage of the materials, and what are the product characterization. It means what kind of product we have, what is the weight of it, what is the size of it, what is the shape is there, and what nature of the product is there, perishable, crushable or hazardous. So these are the factors which are going to finally decide the type of the handling system you are going to adopt. So these are the areas where the my material handling system is connected with several decisions are there. So it is related with the productivity potentials of goods being handled. Hygiene and human safety is one more aspect. Cost implications are there. Minimum dead weight to payload ratio. Compatible to storage system and the warehouse layout. What should be the warehouse layout? It should be there. So that is very important for any manufacturing industry. Here you can see a truck is what you call unloading the item at the input station. This is a pickup station is there. From there, the material which is in the form of a container, now it is moving on the conveyors. So this is the layout which will show you the automated storage and retrieval system. So once this container moves to the a specified place, so there comes what we call it as a storage and retrieval machine, this one. Now the container is been passed to the SR machine, SR machine moves horizontally and vertically, and it identifies the location where we have to keep the material. So here it is storing the material. So after that, the SR machine moves to its initial position. This is the view of inside it. It is a retrieval system. So the SR system has SR machine has moved into the axle. So here you can see that one item has been retrieved from the rack. Now it is coming out of the what you call axle. Now the container will be shifted to the what you call material handling system. So from there it moves to the conveyor belt. So from this conveyor belt, it goes to the what we call it as a delivery station, that is the output station. So this will give even very good idea. So what we are going to discuss in this particular video, that about the ASR system. So it's a very helpful video. Watch it and then listen to my lecturer. Normally, the similar benefits also we can see it by the installation of ASR system. So to increase the storage capacity, to increase the storage density, to utilize maximum floor space, to recover factory floor space currently used for the work in progress, to improve security and reduced pilferage, to reduce labor cost, to improve safety, improve stock rotation, improve customer service. So customer service, if you consider these points, so these are all the benefits. So naturally the storage capacity will increase, because I am having an efficient what you call storing and retrieving system. I need not to worry about the storing the extra things. Okay, so density per space floor, how many items I am going to store, that also increases, because I am going to retrieve it and I am going to store it time to time and perfectly. Maximum floor utilization, I can do it because I can go for the higher heights, because as it is automation machine, it can reach to the any heights. Okay, safety is there. If any hazardous items are there, so the automatic machine can handle it. There is no question of what you call human interference. So safety and hazardous is maintained there. And definitely it will improve the customer service, because the whole manufacturing process activity is dependent on the availability of the raw material, availability of the cutting tools. So movement of the work in progress between the different machines. If everywhere we make use of the automation, naturally we are going to save on the time on the lead system. So when the time is saved, automatically the customer will be happy, because you are going to deliver the goods at the specified dates. A small idea about what do you mean by the automated storage system. Basically, it started with the mechanization. Right now, we are having fully automated systems are there. So, first stage, you can say that it is a mechanized one. The second one is the automation. In automation also, there are two varieties are there. Automated storage and retrieval system, and one more is casserole storage system. So, these are the common storage systems. Generally, we find it in manufacturing industry. Bulk storage, it is nothing but storing the raw material on the floor space around the factory. So next one is the racking system. Steel structures are made and all other items are what you call stocked in this racking system, or we can go for the shelf system, or we may go for the pallets, or we may go for the container. So just one more little more idea about this one. So one is what we call it as a bulk type. So we have to make the what you call several rows and columns. So all are kept on the what you call floor, one over the other. The next one is what we call it as a pallet rock is there, which consists of a frame to support unit loads, one over the other, without the weight of the two most loads resting on loads. Okay, so drive through racks are there. So where you have an access where a vehicle or a AGV can get into the place where it has been stocked, it can retrieve from there, or again it can go and store there. So cantilever racks are there. So these are same as that of pallet racks, except horizontal beams are cantilevered from the vertical cutter. This will leads to what you call less floor is available, then we can go for the cantilever type. Portable racks are there. Flow through racks are also there. Okay. So flow through racks which replace conventional horizontal rack beams. So unit loads are loaded on one side of the rack and they are unloaded on the other side, thus providing the first in first out workstations. Okay. So this is one more idea, a picture where you can see that one racks are there. So then we have got shelves that we have, and cells or sometimes we can call it them as a bins, then drawer type of the storage is there. So this is the what you call table which shows the application characteristics of the various storage equipment and the method. So just what we discussed about bulk storage, rack system, shelves, drawer and automated storage system. So these are the some advantages, disadvantages with the typical applications is given in this particular table. Bulk storage is good when we have a high density is possible, low accessibility is there, then we can go for the bulk storage. So storage of what you call low turn and large stocks, so where we can make use of the bulk storage. Then rack system, low cost, good storage density. Okay, we can store them in a palletized loads in warehouses. Then shelves are there. Okay, so when you talk about the what you call shelves, storage of individual items is the best. If you want to store the materials in individual basis, then shelves are the best one. Drawer type is there. So where we have a small tools and small stocks items or repair parts, we can go for the drawer type of the storage. When we go for the automated storage and retrieval system, this is very good for the work in progress storage, final product, warehousing and distributing center. Okay. So this is a comparison between the different storage system with the advantages and disadvantages with the typical applications of that. So let's define what do you mean by automated storage and retrieval system. So it is defined as a storage system that performs storage and retrieval operations with speed and accuracy under defined degree of automation. So degree of automation is nothing but, so how we are going to handle it. So that will tell you the degree of automation. Okay. So whether your system storing and retrieval, movement of the material, to what level you have automized. So that one we call it as a degree of automation. So the ASRS system is a custom design to fit requirements of the plant in which it is installed. It means depends upon the what you call manufacturing floor pace or the activities taking place on the shop floor. So that will decide that. So what type of ASRS system should be there and what should be its design. So these are the certain what you call storage systems which we use it in automated storage and retrieval system. So this particular diagram is very helpful for you. So you can see that there are different racks are there. So we have certain nomenclature for this one. So you are supposed to know about this nomenclature of the storage structure. So there is a length of rack is there, height of rack is there, width of rack is there. I need not to say that one, how many items we can store it, that will decide the length, breadth and the height. Then in each storage, so how much space is available, that one we call it as a what you call storage capacity. Then we have some gaps between these rows, those we call them as the axles. And to handle these axles, we have what we call it as a SR system. What SR system is there, just I will explain you later. But this is the basic structure. So these are the different parameters through which we speak about the storage structure. That is, axle is there, length, breadth, okay, storage bin. So this is the second component of our ASR system. That is storage and retrieval machine. So you can see that one here is a small machine is there which can move in horizontal way as well as it can be moved up and down. So the pallets or what you call containers that can be kept on this small what you call lift. So this lift can move be moved upwards, downwards, it can move horizontally. So using this what you call horizontal and vertical movement, we can place the material in any of the racks. So next is we have got a variety of what you call storage modules are there. So unit load is the one variety is there. So unit load is what? So where the components are of typical variety. So where we need to store them individual one. So then that one we call it as a unit load one. The SR machines are automated and designed to handle the unit load container. So usually a mechanical clamp mechanization on the SR machine handles the load. However, nowadays there are different mechanisms are there such as vacuum and magnet. That all depends upon the kind of raw material you are going to handle it. If it is a glass type of the material is there, then definitely we have to go for this particular type of what you call a unit load system. So deep line ASRS system. What do you mean by the deep line? As name indicates, we can able to store the materials in deep. So it means what? We can store the material not only in the racks vertical wise, even in horizontal wise. It means what? In one particular rack, you may have different rows inside it. So that is what you mean by the deep line. So the items are stored in multi deep storage with up to 10 items in a single rack, one load behind the next. So each rack is designed for the flow through with input and output on the opposite side. Okay, the machine is used to enter the side of the rack for input load and loads are retrieved from the other side. So we can store the items in deep in a horizontal way. So then comes what we call it as a mini load ASRS system. So this system is designed to handle small loads such as individual parts, tools, okay, supplies that are contained in a bins or the drawers. Okay, this particular mini load type of the what you call system is used where availability of space is limited one. So it also finds its use where volume is too low for the full scale unit load systems, too high for a manual system. So this is what we call it as a mini load. Men on board ARS systems are there. It means what? So along with the your storage and retrieval system, I am going to have a person who is sitting on it and he is assisting or he is doing the what you call storing and retrieval of the items depending upon the requirement. So then we have a automated retrieval system. So one more is what we call it as a vertical lift storage. So this is what we call it as a similar to the horizontal one, only in this case we have a space in the vertical direction also. Okay, the same principle as that of the ASRS system followed, except that instead of a horizontal axle, we can have a vertical axle. Axle is nothing but it has small vertical lines of the racks which we have kept in a row. How we arrange it in a horizontal way, same we can have a in the vertical direction. So these are the few YouTube links I have put it. You can go and watch them. So the performance of ASRS system depends upon these particular items. That is what we call it as a storage capacity, storage density, accessibility. Another three are there that we will discuss it later. The storage capacity is nothing but it talks about the total volume which is available for you Okay, the storage density is defined as volumetric space available for the storage relative to the total volumetric space in the storage facility. Okay, so density normally we define it as a mass by volume, is it not? The same way here, in a given particular volume, so how many items we can store it, that is represented by what we call it as a storage density. Next is the accessibility. So basically it refers to the access, any desired items or the load stored in the system. So we are storing it in the racks, but how easily we can reach to that particular item, so that is what we call it as accessibility. More the accessibility is there, better the system is there. So one more performance parameter is there, what we call it as a system throughput. It means what? So it talks about the what you call, how many number of what you call items are coming in, going out of your ASR system. So it is dependent on the what you call time. That is, it receive how many items are received and loads are put into the storage, that will decide what we call it as a system throughput. So typical storage transaction consists of the following what you call elements: pick up load at the input station, so travel to the storage location, place load into the storage location, travel back to input station. A retrieval transaction consists of a travel to location, pick up item from the storage, travel to the output station. Remember, here everywhere we are having what we call it as a P&D system, that is pick up and delivery systems. Every ASR system is associated with one pick up and delivery. The total process is what? It writes from start from the picking of the storage, moving it to the SR machine, then reaching it to the particular location in the as well, store it. This is the activities of the storing. If you consider of the retrieval one, it starts with the movement of the SR machine, reaching the location inside the what you call as well. It has to move horizontally, it has to move vertically, then it has to go to the location, then it has to retrieve it, again it has to come back, and it should reach to the output station. So utilization is the one more performance activity. So like machine utilization, how efficiently my ASR system is used. So normally we look for 80% to 90% of the utilization. The next one is the very availability. So that also can be called as a reliability. How reliable is your ASR system is one of the performance factor that is to be discussed, because the reliability will decide the efficiency of the ASR systems. So with this I will conclude on the what you call a topic on automated storage and retrieval system. In next video I will talk about the automatic identification and data capturing.